So I generally don't make videos, but I've been getting a lot of questions about equipment, about software, about what graphic tablets to get, about iPad and so on. So I thought, why not make a video and answer all of these questions at once? But when I sat to write, I figured it's going to be quite a few things. So here's part one of A Beginner's Guide to Digital Art. I'm only talking about these things from my own experience. There may be better devices out there. These are the ones I have and use regularly. In the first video, I'm going to talk about equipment because this is the most asked question and a lot of people don't know where to start from or what equipment to invest in. But before we proceed, I would like to make something clear. A lot of people believe that you can do the same things with a mouse or a laptop trackpad. Well, you can't. And the main reason is this: a stylus which provides you with control that a mouse cannot. And of course, the pressure sensitivity. When you draw a line and you apply pressure on the tablet with your stylus, you see the lines get thicker. That's because of pressure sensitivity, which means whatever pressure you apply with your hand is what is reflected in your lines. When you try to make the same lines with a mouse, you see it's pretty uniform in shape. That is because a mouse does not support pressure sensitivity. Now that we've established why we need a graphic tablet, let's discuss the different types. I have a pen tablet, a pen display, and an iPad. This is what a pen tablet looks like. It comes with a stylus. I have an old one, which I used for about 4 years before it gave up on me. It's a Wacom Intuos. I currently use one by Wacom. It has no hotkeys because I never really use mine. The pens have been really easy to draw with. It did take me some time when I switched between the devices because I was not used to of the other one, but neither of these have ever been uncomfortable to work with. The Wacom Intuos costed me 14,000 rupees when I bought it in 2014. I bought the one by Wacom for 17,000 rupees last year from a vendor in Islamabad. It's one of the latest models in the series, I believe. So the pen display that I have is called Canvas Pro 13 by Huion. Now, I haven't used it much since I just got it 2 months ago and I have mostly had projects going on my iPad. This, however, is pretty similar to a pen tablet because you still need a computer with it and a keyboard as well. But since you're drawing on a screen, I find it a bit more precise and more convenient. On this device, I do, however, use the hotkeys because it's easier than using a keyboard for very basic shortcuts. This costed me about 64,000 Pakistani rupees because I ordered it off the Huion website and a friend brought it here for me from the UK. The price will vary depending on where you're ordering it from and the duties. iPad. I may sound a bit biased towards this device, but I absolutely love working on it. The fact that it does not need to be connected to a PC makes it so much more convenient to work on. You can literally just sit anywhere and start working. The pressure sensitivity on this thing is so great, it sometimes feels like I'm working on a paper. This is probably going to be comparatively more expensive than the other options. I'm using an iPad Pro 2017, 12.9 inches, which I bought in 2018. It costed me about 100K with the Apple Pencil, but these devices cost a lot more now since the new models have come out. You'll find it in two different sizes, a 9.7 inch one and a 12.9 inch one. I think the bigger one gives you more space to draw, especially if you have gigantic hands like me. And you have to buy the pencil separately. As a beginner, I highly recommend you get one of the pen tablets because they cost a lot less than the other options. You don't need to sit and wait until you can spend thousands on a more expensive device. There are Huion options in the market that cost less than 10,000 rupees and work just as well as the Wacom ones.
I hope this was helpful. Please like, share, and subscribe. I have always wanted to say that.